Lord Jesus, send us your Spirit, renew the face of the earth. Come, Lord Jesus, send us your Spirit, renew the face of the earth. Come to us, Spirit of God, breathe in us now, we sing together. Spirit of hope and of light, fill our lives. Come to us, Spirit of God. Come, Lord Jesus, send us your Spirit. Renew the face of the earth. Come, Lord Jesus, send us your Spirit.
Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Happy birthday to you all. Happy birthday to Mother Church. Pentecost has been dedicated by our Lord to the apostles first to form the church. The birth of the church where we have a community that is full of love and full of the guidance of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit that dwells within us, the Spirit that would always be accompanying us in our journey here in this world. On this Pentecost Sunday, which is the last Sunday of the Easter season, we want to welcome again the Holy Spirit and make Him dwell in our lives. To the Holy Spirit, to heal us, Lord, have mercy. To the Holy Spirit, to guide us, and you give us the truth, Christ, have mercy. And to the Holy Spirit, you give us harmony, unity, and peace, Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the mystery of today's great feast sanctify your whole church in every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth, and with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of believers to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together. And suddenly, there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each of them. and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in different tongues, as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astounded, and in amazement, they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, and Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converted to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs. Yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty acts of God." The word of the Lord. The response is, "Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth." Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. How manifold are your works, O Lord. The earth is full of your creatures. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord be glad in his works. Blessing to him be my theme. I will be glad in the Lord. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. If you take away their breath, they perish and return to their dust. When you send forth your Spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God, who proceeds all of them in everyone. In each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given in some benefit. As a body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For in one Spirit we are all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free person, and we are all given to drink of one Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked, where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in the midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. All of us would want harmony. All of us would want unity. Would it be that we could be reconciled with ourselves, our body, our mind, and our spirit would be united? Or if we are always thinking of family, that our family is always united, and then from there, the family with the community, that the community would always be united. Harmony and unity. That was also the prayer of the apostles. The apostles were thinking of harmony. They were asking the Lord to give them harmony. When the Lord was persecuted, crucified, and died, there was some chaos within that community of the apostles. And so what they do? What did they do? They gathered and they prayed together, praying to the Father that they would be united. Prayer is a prerequisite of harmony and unity. When the Lord Jesus visited the apostles for several times after his resurrection, because the apostles were still fearing the Jews, fearing the Romans, fearing for persecution, he found them praying. He found them asking God in prayer, praying to God. Prayer is a prerequisite for unity and harmony. This is the message that we can get from this Pentecost Sunday, my dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate this birthday of our church. That the Lord is asking us to pray always, to pray to God the Father. But He is sending us the Holy Spirit to guide us with our prayer, that our prayer would always be united with their prayer. And it is the Spirit that is the bridge. Who is the bridge between us and God with the Son? As God and the Son are praying together, the Spirit is in between them as God, the Holy Spirit, sending us to be an advocate of our prayer. Prayer is a prerequisite of harmony and unity. We want unity in ourselves, we pray. We want unity for our families, we pray. For our community, and especially in a community where there are many talents, as the second reading would tell us, as we are given the gifts of the Holy Spirit, each one accordingly with the Spirit's gifts. We are different, but yet we could be united through prayer. As we ask the Lord for the Spirit again, and we welcome Him on this Pentecost, we want to assure Him that He has a place in our hearts. But we want also to assure ourselves of this unity with the Father. And so to do this, we are asked to give some time of prayer. Whether that be prayer, that prayer would be an act of thanksgiving, an act of petition, or just a prayer in question or questioning something, to give the Lord a time to answer us. When we are happy in the joy and celebrations of our lives, we pray. In the trials, tribulations, and challenges of our lives, we pray. In the many things that we could not control here in this world, the Lord is asking us to pray. The apostles, they were not in control of many things after the Lord's crucifixion. They feared the Jews. They feared even those people who are knocking at the door, but they were praying. May we always have that time of prayer and renew again on this Pentecost Sunday, birthday of our family, of our church, that we would be men and women of prayer. Indeed, this is the last day of the Easter season. In front of our altar is the Easter candle, which is our light, our symbol of Christ's light. Our symbol also that Christ is the light and is enlightening all of us in our prayer. After the Mass, I would be processing this candle back to the church. We don't have the opportunity of seeing always the Paschal candle in this outdoor Mass, but normally if we are inside, we see this Paschal candle during the Easter season in an important place, closer to the ambo, to the lectern, or to the baptismal font, in front where we are reminded of Christ who is enlightening us with our prayer. I'll be processing this candle back to the church as a sign that we are ending the Easter season. But yet in that ending of the Easter season, we are given the task and the mission, just like the apostles, with prayer. The mission to give God to the world and to be the light and the salt of the earth for others. On this Pentecost Sunday also, we would be renewing our baptismal vows again. The last time of this Easter season, as we were not able to sprinkle ourselves with the holy water, I would be sprinkling holy water to you as we profess our faith. Even socially distanced, but yet the Spirit of our Lord would bless all of us and renew the face of the earth, renewing all of us. May the Holy Spirit come to us and would link our prayer to the prayer of the Father, because prayer is a prerequisite of unity and harmony. Amen. I ask you, my dear brothers and sisters, to renew your profession of faith. You renew your vows to the Lord as I ask you these questions. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
Amen.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord?
Amen.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
Amen.
This is our faith, and this is the faith of the church. We are proud to profess in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Receive the blessing again as I sprinkle holy water to you, although distant, but yet the Holy Spirit will not be distant to you as he blesses you. Confident that God hears our prayers because the Holy Spirit would bring all our prayers to the Father, uniting all our prayers to his prayers. And we are in harmony with him. We give our prayers. We pray for the church, that we'd always be a beacon of hope, salt of the earth, a light of the world. And as we are in a mission, a mission to proclaim the good news of our Lord. May we always be attuned in prayer to the Father, with the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord. For unity, peace, and justice, for the end of any kind of violence, especially against human life. As these gifts of the Holy Spirit will be given to us, as we are human beings, because we have life, we pray that our life would always be open to the gifts of the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit would work with us and make us instruments of God's mission and will in this world. We pray to the Lord. In our bulletin this Sunday, there's an insert of the pastoral letter of Archbishop Cordiglione. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Life is very important. Life is delicate. Life is basic and fundamental. The Spirit would work only within us if we have life. We respect life from conception to natural death. We defend life at all costs. We defend also those who are most vulnerable within us. The babies in the womb and all of us who are struggling, who would need some defense. We pray that there is always a defense of life and that we would always promote life so that the Spirit would dwell in us and to work with us because there's life. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the end of this pandemic as we are slowly going back to normalcy. May we always be free from the virus, protected always by our Lord. We pray that all those who are sick would be healed, and that they would have some medicines, therapeutics for them, and for the efficacies of these medicines, we pray to the Lord. We pray for those who are traveling, that they would find a destination safe and sound. Many of them can travel now with the restrictions lifted more and more. We pray to the Lord. We continue to pray for those who are in our convalescent homes, in San Mateo General Hospital, in the 25 care facilities surrounding our parish. We are united with them, that their spirit would be lifted to God. Even though they are sick, that their souls could be strong through prayer. We pray to the Lord. And we pray also for those who are celebrating birthdays, anniversaries, and many occasions of life. We pray for Celia. We pray also for Vitz. And for all those who are united with them in prayer, as they may not be able to celebrate together, but the Lord would give them joy to the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, that they would find rest in Christ. Those who have died from our own parish and from our own families, and those who may have been forgotten already. These are prayers, and the prayers that are in our hearts, we ask through the intercession of our Blessed Mother, as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Continue to follow some protocols here in our parish for our safety. Some guidelines are still followed. We are still using our mask until we are told by the Archdiocese with the safety department. We want to assure you also of our work and our collaboration with the Archdiocese and with the county, as slowly we are going back to some sort of normalcy with our schedules here in the parish. I want to thank you for your continued support to the parish, for your offertory at the entrance. You have given your offertory contribution. If you are not ready, you could always give them at the exits with our ushers, or you could just mail. We want to thank all our ushers for volunteering always. If there are some of you who can volunteer sometime to be an usher or to be in the registration committee, please let us know. I want to thank our ushers who had always been there. Some of them were here even yesterday's Mass or this morning's Mass at the 9 o'clock Mass, and they're still here for the 11:30 Mass. If you want to be an usher, you could always talk after this Mass to our head usher, Aaron Gilbert. Aaron, if you can, raise your hand, and he would be able to guide you and give you some training of ushering. As we would be going back also to normal schedule, we need more ushers that we would be safer. Thank you for your continued patience. Now, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours would become acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Grant, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of this sacrifice, and graciously lead us into all truth through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always ever to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, for bringing your Paschal mystery to completion. You bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise as we sing together when we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts to pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be put out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that ever is worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Salvatore, our Archbishop, and all the clergy, we pray also for our government leaders and for the end of this pandemic. We pray also for those who are sick, Lily San Agustin, Rita McKelly, David Piccianini, Sophia Smith. And we pray also for those who are celebrating birthdays, anniversaries, and many occasions of life, Celia Perlas, with shed of blood. And all those who have died, most especially Christina Garvey and Susana Bautista, with Sister Agnes Rebno. Bring them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, O Lord, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Gregory the Great, our patron, and all the saints, all the apostles, as they have pleased you throughout the ages, promoting unity, we may come together in the unity of faith. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. United, and as we want to be in harmony always, we have one Father who would do that for us, for our prayer, with the Lord's Prayer. And so united with them, we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us offer each other the sign of peace, socially distanced." Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. For behold, Jesus, he is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, who with the Father has given us the Holy Spirit to be our advocate, to unite us, and to make us a family, a community with harmony. Happy are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
We are
I want to congratulate all our members of the newly formed Knights of Columbus Council here in our parish. We want to support them with prayer. We want to support them also with our membership if you are available. For all the men who are here, may you find time if you want to have some spirituality in the world we are facing today. The Knights of Columbus would be a good way for us to have some community of prayer, community of service. I ask our president of the Knights of Columbus here in the Archdiocese of San Francisco, Ed Dantas, to give us an invitation with Robert, who is our grand knight in our parish, just newly installed.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Hi, my name is Ed Dantes. I'm the president of the St. Francis Chapter of Knights of Columbus, representing the Archdiocese of San Francisco. And I just wanted to come today to congratulate the new council that was just recently formed in the past month. With today's gospel being today being Pentecost, the birthday of the church, and celebrating last weekend with the Ascension, we are charged with the great commission that Jesus left us with to go forth and to make disciples of all nations and to evangelize to all the ends of the earth. Well, our Knights of Columbus is a vehicle to do all those things through our faith and action programs. So all the gentlemen that you see with Brother Robert, step forward. So Brother Robert, who is the Grand Knight or presiding officer of the council, he's wearing one of those Knights of Columbus masks that you might be seeing. It says, "Leave no neighbor behind," with our logo. I am not wearing one at this point, but I'm sure you we have badges as well. So if I can ask all the brothers who are part of this new council to rise and join me up front here so you can be recognized. And while I'm doing that, I also want to acknowledge the presence of the district officer in charge. He is a mentor to me and to many of our Knights of Columbus, Brother Romy Quevedo. If I can please have him stand in front here as well. He's our district deputy, as identified by his red badge. So this is the newly formed council, St. Gregory's Council, Council 17709. If we can give them a round of applause. They are our council chaplains, so they are very, very important to the spiritual lifeline of our order, because we were founded by a parish priest in 1882 by Blessed Father Michael McGivney. He was only 29 years old when he founded the Knights of Columbus, not too much younger than me and Brother Robert. But we are here to be of service to the church. We are here to be an army for God here at the parish. And we look forward to building relationships with you. And we invite you, especially at the birthday of the church, with a birthday invite to join our council here at 17709. So if you are a practicing Catholic male over the age of 18 years old, we invite you to join with your families, because we are the largest Catholic family fraternal organization in the world. So right now, we are 2 million brothers strong as of current. And with these gentlemen here that just became exemplified as Knights of Columbus, we have 2 million, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and down the road. So if you are interested, we will be here after Mass. If you would like to talk to us and ask us some questions, we will be here as a permanent presence for Father. So you can always see us here every Sunday. They will be ushering and helping out with the ushering duties here to start off their ministry. So if you want to become an usher, if you're looking forward to doing that, we also invite you to join our Knights of Columbus, because the majority of our brother knights are ushers and extraordinary ministers of the Eucharist at every parish. So we send an invite to you, and with the birthday of the church, we'd like to give this present to St. Gregory's. So with that, thank you very much. God bless you, and happy Sunday.
I want to take this opportunity also to thank Brother Ed, who is the president of the whole Archdiocesan Knights of Columbus Council, for bringing this together, for forming this Council 17709 with Brother Romy and all the Ed Palomar. They came here to train us and to give us all these, all the lectures, classes, and a retreat for exemplification, that we would be knowing more about the Knights of Columbus and be able to minister the church to the Knights of Columbus. So thank you so much on behalf of thanking Jared.
And thank you very much, Father Mark, for allowing us to build here, and also for being my chapter chaplain for the 2020-2021 Columbian year. So thank you very much for all the spiritual guidance you've given us. God bless you.
That's why you did not respond good morning, because it's afternoon already, probably. It's afternoon already. We enjoy the sun. We enjoy this fresh weather. We want to thank the Lord as we pray. O God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, that the gifts of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Don't forget also to get a copy of your bulletin to guide you with activities here. And as I've said, we are going back to normalcy. And we hope that June 15 would really be a great event for us. And what our government leaders have told us, we'll be able to implement that in our parishes. So take a copy of the bulletin. And in the insert of the bulletin is a beautiful pastoral letter of Archbishop Cordiglione, our Archbishop here in San Francisco, for us to meditate upon the gift of the Holy Spirit and the gift of life. The Lord be with you. And may the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I want to thank also Michelle for being our music director and music pianist. And Marvin, our tech director, who would live stream on all the masses to our parishioners who may not be able to come here. Thank you so much. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Happy birthday to our Mother Church.
Thank you.